students of class 6. I hope you all are doing well at home. Okay, today I am here to take your grammar class. Today I will teach you on noun skills. We have learned about nouns, nouns gender, nouns number, and today we will learn noun skills. Okay, so what is the case? A noun may be used as a subject or object of a verb or to show position. So we said that the noun is in the nominative, objective, or possessive respectively. Okay? So now we will learn in details what is nominative case, what is possessive objective case, and what is possessive case. First of all, what is nominative case? What is nominative case? When a noun is used as a subject of a verb, it is said that noun is said to be in the nominative case. For example, Gita played football. Okay, here Rita, the noun Rita is the doer of the action. Okay, so in other words, when the noun is the doer of the action, that noun is said to be in the subjective case. Okay, subjective case or nominative case. Alright, now what is objective case? Okay, when a noun is used as an object of a verb, it is said to be in the objective case. For example, let's say the ball hit Rita. And here Rita is now is used as an object. Okay, Rita is receiving the action of the verb. Okay, so Rita is now is used as an object in this sentence. So this noun is said to be in the objective case. Okay, now we go to possessive case. What is the possessive case? When a noun shows a position or when a noun shows something belong to someone, that noun is said to be in the possessive case. For example, this is Meena's dress. Okay, here this noun shows possession. Okay, the dress belong to Meena. Okay, so this noun is said to be in the possessive case. Okay, now let us learn how to form possessive case. Alright, so the possessive case of a singular noun is formed by adding an apostrophe and s to it. For example, here the dog is singular noun, right? So we get here apostrophe and s. The dog's leg was hurt. But if the singular nouns, if the singular noun ends in s, then for example, this is James. James is a singular James. Okay, James is a singular noun. Okay, but James, okay, it ends in s, so we only apostrophe is accepted. Even if we put apostrophe and s, also accepted. Okay, if the singular noun ends in s, only apostrophe is accepted. Okay, this is James' car. And even if you add apostrophe and s, that is also both are accepted. Okay, so if the noun ends in s, both apostrophe, okay, only apostrophe is accepted, and apostrophe s also accepted. Okay, but if the noun is plural, if the noun is plural, like the uniforms of the nurses, the uniforms, okay, of the nurses. Here, nurses, okay, nurses, this is plural noun and it ends in s. Okay, so here we need only apostrophe. Okay, the uniforms of the nurses, the nurses. We will write like this, the nurses. Here only apostrophe, okay? You cannot use s here. The nurses' uniforms. Okay? This plural noun ends in s, so we need only apostrophe. So if the plural nouns do not end in s, for example, the same for women. Women is a plural noun, but it doesn't end in s, right? It ends in n. So we need the same for women's. Here we need apostrophe and s. Okay, women's gym. And apostrophe and s only with living beings. Okay, we do not use apostrophe and s in non-living things. For example, you don't say the chair's legs. Okay, this is wrong. Instead, you say the legs of the chair. Okay, now we use apostrophe with nouns denoting space, time, and weight. We said a month's day, a meter's length, a day's stay. Okay, alright. One thing I did not tell you, when the non-living things are personified, then only we use apostrophe and s. For example, his school's progress. Okay, their school is non-living thing, but it is personified. Okay, his school's progress. So in that case, we use apostrophe and s here. Okay, now let us do some exercises from your book. I have written here exercise A number 1. I will do exercise B number 1. The rest we do at home, alright? Okay. Exercise A, read the sentences given below and pick out nouns in the nominative case. So, here the sun sets in the west. Right? Here the noun is the sun. Okay? The sun, this noun is used as a subject in this sentence. Okay? So, this noun is in the nominative case. Alright? Exercise B, I gifted my friends bars of chocolates. Now, what you need to do with this is, you are to circle the direct object and underline the indirect object. Okay? So, now we are going to find out what is direct object, what is indirect object in this sentence. In order to find a direct object, you need to ask question to the verb. Okay? A question word, that is what or whom. Alright? So, you ask the question, what here to the verb, I gifted what? The answer you find is the direct object. Okay, I gifted what? Bars of chocolates. Okay, so you have to circle the direct object. Bars of chocolate is the direct object. So in order to find out indirect object, you need to ask whom to the verb. Okay, I gifted whom. Okay, the question word whom for indirect object. The answer you find is indirect object. I gifted whom? My friends. Okay? So you got the answer after asking whom to the verb, and this is indirect object. Okay? This is indirect object. This is direct object. Okay? Yeah, now we have here exercise A number 1. Here, the telephone owned by John. Now we are going to put this noun in the possessive form. So we write like this. The telephone owned by John means telephone belongs to John, right? So we write like this, John's telephone. Yeah, exercise D. Number 1, the costumes of the participants. The costumes belong to the participants. Okay, now participants, this is plural noun. Okay, we write like this, the participants. Remember, this is a plural noun and it ends in s. So we need only apostrophe. Okay, here only apostrophe, no need of s. Right? The participants' costumes. Okay, and the dog's legs. Okay, and this one is make the expressions plural. Okay, this is a singular noun, right? So you have to. You have to change this one in the plural noun, right? The dog's legs. Okay, then dogs, this is singular. Now dogs, plural, okay? So this is plural noun. It ends in S, so we need only here S. The dog's legs. Okay, I think that's all for today.
Stay home, stay safe, do it for yourselves, do it for your family. Big for India, let's break the chain of COVID-19. Hum Honge Kamyab, Jai Hind.